Hi, welcome to my channel. My name is Exquisite. Today's topic is on domestic violence awareness and different signs. It's all different types of signs of it, and more of us women need to really speak up some kind of way. We keep having all these different codes. A lot of us is not using them. A lot of us is really scared to speak up because of what we think others are gonna think of us, or not even just that, because from experience myself, because your family would get threatened, or you know, your life would get threatened. It's just like things that I've never shared with people. Yes, I have went through, and I'm not throwing any names out there, but just know that I went through it. And after my daughter, I just couldn't do it anymore. I really couldn't. I feel like at the age of 16, I was mentally beat up. So if you go figure back to age 16 and who I was with, then you'll know. But which I shouldn't have never, ever been with him. He was older than me and everything else, but you know, life experiences, and that's where the Vernicia experience come in at, because I've had a lot of experiences. Well, I've been like shot at on supposedly accident. I'm not sure how that went. I was 7 months pregnant with my daughter, arguing with her dad and about leaving. He wanted to leave and go with someone that he was, you know, dealing with. I kept telling him, please leave me alone, please leave me alone. He wouldn't leave me alone. He just was a narcissist. I never checked on what a narcissist and a manipulator was until now. I'm actually 38 years old, but that's been over 10 years. So I never had checked into what that was, but I had never even really heard of it until now. It's more of a popular word. But that's exactly what he was. He wanted to keep me around because I was a go-getter. I'm always going to be a go-getter. Been working since I was 15 years old, and that's what I guess he loved, because he's still proud on females like that. But I was taken care of home. I had a son that my parents helped me take care of. I was a teen mom. I'll get into that on another video. But so you know, I had to do what I had to do, and I guess he's seen the opportunity. Another thing is guy prowl on women that they know can get government assistance, get some food stamps, get some cachet, as long as they got a kid. They know that they'll never be broke. But then the thing about it is bills and stuff come in with that, rent and bills. So something that a narcissist or a manipulator, most of them don't care. What should I say? A leech. That's a sign of abuse right there. Nobody should be leeching off nobody. It's the worst pain, the worst feeling in the world. Felt like my whole life, like it was on pause, and I didn't really notice it until I finally got out of the relationship, I guess, because I had worked so much, and I mean, the whole entire time I was being cheated on. You know, when you work so much, you really don't pay no attention, but then stuff would keep coming up, and it's like, okay, well, I'm telling you to leave, and I'm getting hit over my head, or you know, threatened, or however. I mean, it was bad. It was real bad. I mean, it'll be days that I could fill my car up with gas just to go to work, 5 in the morning. This narcissist manipulator would get in my car. By the time I get home, I guess he have everything planned and scheduled by the time I get home from work, and just leave right after, you know, and go run my gas out and have a jolly good time, you know, and different things. And it's like, hold on, come back 5 in the morning. I gotta go put gas in my car because, you know, he done ran my gas out and stuff and sat at home all day long and ran up light bill, gas bill, and some old stuff, you know, sitting there eating and all that, just living a life, making plans while I'm out working, slaving. This was before my daughter. Once I had my daughter, I really, really realized that, like, man, this gotta end. This really gotta end. My parents had even told me, like, nah. And they helped me out a lot, just, you know, as far as if I ever need anything and they knew that I can, you know, give it back or however. We were spoiled. We were really, really spoiled. That's another thing a lot of narcissists and manipulators look at. They look at the females that's spoiled, that's family gonna, you know, mom and dad, that's gonna be there for them. And they prey on them type of women. I'm telling you, it's all types of domestic violence, abuse out there, and red flags that we don't pay attention to, because not all of us, I can say, are in relationships and, you know, sticking around for the kids, because a lot of people don't have kids that's sticking around in relationships. They just sticking around, you know, looking in love. I call it too, looking in love, looking for love in all the wrong places. I know mine's had a lot to do with childhood trauma from, you know, being a black sheep. I'll put that on another video. And I'm not talking about from my mom and dad at all, but family trauma. And I really, really looked for love in all the wrong places, not just with relationships, but with friends too. And that's a whole nother subject too, but that's what I call that. And it took me years to really just forgive myself. I had to been like at least about 35, because I used to say that was my biggest regret. But I used to say it without knowing how to not regret my kids. Not saying that I regret my kids, but they, father, was literally my biggest regret. And my son's dad, I shouldn't have nowhere way been with him. And like I said, that's another subject for being a teen mom. But it was just like I was really being preyed over. What I say, hoodwinked, bamboozled, and hoodwinked. But man, please, please, the message that I really want to get out is, please talk to someone, because I know what it feels like to have to jump out of windows after being accused of somebody that you had no imagine that you would even, you know, like, where did you get that from, you know, being accused. I have been accused so many times of people that I didn't even really know who they were, you know. And it's like what they say, the accuser is the one doing the cheating, and that's exactly what was happening. But I was the one being punished for it. And you know, it used to be crazy, like, you'll go somewhere and I'll be getting rushed home and stuff, you know, in my own car, just so this person can get in my car and leave and just go cheat, you know, come back home drunk, super drunk. And, you know, it's nothing I could really do about it, because I was scared. I was really scared. Only if you knew the threats, like I said, threatened to, oh, go do this to my parents' house, or, you know, all this other extra stuff. It's like, it's a mind thing. And then when you come, it's like, people really be cowards when it come down to it. It's just that a lot of guys, they're pushovers with females. You won't see them doing that with no guy at all. And it's like, another thing is the phone. The phone be the first thing to go. Every single time, the phone be the first thing to go. Because then they want to snatch your phone and make sure that you ain't calling the police or calling, you know, for help or something like that. So the phone is always being broken and different things. That's another thing people need to start paying attention to. It's when someone always talking about their phone is broke. I'm not talking about broke. Maybe the volume or something is not working, or, you know, the speaker or something, because, you know, we can get water inside of it or something. But no, I'm talking about always cracked, or I don't have it, or, you know, I just updated this phone and all that other extra stuff. No, that's crazy. That's real crazy. Another thing is make sure that you get you a man and pay attention to, say, for instance, like if you want to go out with friends or family, and I'm not talking about going out doing no, you know, bad stuff or anything. I'm talking about going out to women empowerment meetings, or just, you know, doing women empowerment stuff and it's an issue, you know, pay attention to that, because from then to now, you know, I could take girl trips, don't have no issue, no problems with the mate that I'm with, my man that I'm with now. And then it was like, I didn't know what it felt like to be able to go out and be a normal human being. It was always like, oh, you need to, you know, be here, like as if maybe I'm gonna go out and tell somebody how messed up of an individual, you know, that this person is, and they trying to protect it or something, you know. That's kind of like really, really what it seemed like to me. But ladies, please beware. Talk to your daughters. Talk to your friends, the ones that keep going back and forth. It's like, if it didn't work out the first, I figure nobody should be breaking up, you know, like that. If it's really something going on deep down inside, it got to be something going on for people to keep breaking up and doing all this extra stuff. And then watch too, a lot of people, when they break up, they start talking about it on social media. They'll throw little, you know, hints out there, but then turn right back around and be back in the same situation. And it's like, wait a minute, you was just throwing all them hints out there like that. Like, come on now, wake up, smell the coffee. Because at this point now, I can see where it's never going to change. You know, you could just see some relationships where it's never going to change. It's like women, us as women, we need to start waking up, smelling the coffee, literally waking up, smelling the coffee and spreading the word, because it's been a lot of women that's been coming up missing. Then at the end, they saying, oh, it was all kind of red flags and, you know, this and that. And, you know, a lot of people don't like getting in other people's relationship problems. Yes, I do understand that, but we need to start having resources for these people so they can get away. You know, I'm into helping a person. I had to actually tell a neighbor that my neighbor that I didn't really even know, but I had ended up talking to her because it was the end, and I wanted someone to know that I'm gonna be leaving this relationship, and you might hear some stuff over here, or I might need, you know, to yell help or, you know, scream something, and I'm gonna need help. So what I did was, I had my daughter's birthday. I had put all of her new stuff over there at my neighbor's house, and a little bit of stuff that I wanted to take for me. But man, when I'm done, I was done. I didn't care what I left. And I had put stuff over there. I had my mom to come pick me up, and I told him, I said I was gonna go washing. I said, I'm gonna go wash at my mom's house. And I had all kind of stuff stacked underneath clothes too, inside of the basket, and I had his clothes in a bag, and I set the bag like somewhere, I can't even remember where I set the bag at, but I set the bag so where his clothes could be in there, and then my clothes was only in the basket. And my daughter, she always had her own basket of clothes, and dirty basket of clothes. So I did that, and my mom came pick me up. I hurry up, went to my neighbor house. She already knew everything, just passed everything, just straight out the door, and I left. He called like 2 days later, like, when are you guys coming back? I said, I'm not. He said, I had a feeling that you wasn't. He said, because you took too much stuff. I said, yeah, this was the only way that I was going to be able to leave. And once I got the opportunity and the chance, I did it. I went for it. My parents had moved. I made sure I kept instilling in their head, do not tell him where you guys live at. If you guys tell him where you guys live at, I won't be coming over at all. And I was serious about that because I just wanted to, you know, leave that alone. Certain things you just gotta just leave alone. And it was horrible. It was really, really, really horrible for years. And I can actually say I have overcome all of that. I have no regrets. You know, just living and learning, staying woke, I'm prayed up, noticing red flags. I actually was single for like 7 years after that. And I mean, when I tell you it was the best time of my life, it was the best time of my life to find me. And when I found me, I was unstoppable. I was already unstoppable then, but you know, like I said, I was being preyed on with the E, not the A. So with that being said, please tell someone. Also, feel free to drop some in the comments, some other signs of domestic violence awareness, red flags, what we will say. So us, you know, as women and other women can know, because it's not always just physically, it's mentally and emotionally and some more stuff. But be strong, and I will catch you in my next video.